onwards, you will this entrepreneurial subject will I'm handing over the subject to Mr. Asanka Pathiran. You know the lecturer. So Pathiran sir will carry on the balance for 2-5 sessions, and then from the last two or last one session again I am back, right? So from next week onwards, around 4-5 sessions, Asanka sir, Pathiran sir will do, right, this subject from next week onwards, right? Okay, I think your assignments deadlines are almost over. I think I have assignments now, so I am still not reviewing it. So I have a time, because I can manage the reviewing part within next 2 or 3 weeks. Right, so that is the plan today and the next sessions, right? So let me share the screen. So right, told was from next week onwards, this entrepreneurial subject will be done by Pathiran sir, and then for the last and the for last two lectures, yes, probably last two lectures, I will be able to back again, and we'll do some practical things, and then the last session we'll do some revision kind of thing, right? So then you will have a good understanding about the subject, and no worries to face in the exam, right? So, but however, I continue with the B2 batch due to this official stuff. I'm not able to cope with the Monday evening, right, for next few weeks. That's why I discuss the university and then share the sessions, right? Okay. Right, in your business plan, so I'm already discussed this, apart from this marketing plan, this marketing plan thing will be done by the Pathiran sir. Apart from that, I have covered, and the risk, this also done by the Pathiran sir. So apart from that, I have done all these things, and today I am going to do this financial plan thing, right? So that is one of the important part in the your important part in your business plan, right? Okay, right, let me stop share this. I'm sharing this Excel sheet. Is this Excel sheet visible?
Yes sir.
Right, okay. Now in the financial plan, so you have to plan, or you have to estimate. Basically, this is the estimate, right? Because your business is still not started, right? So you have to estimate your revenue, your cost of your product, the manufacturing cost, right? And expected demand. How much you can sell to the customer in the first year, second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year. Likewise, you have to estimate, right? The financial plan, it is all about the estimate, right? අපි ඉස්සරහ බලනවා අපිට කොච්චරක් විකුණ ගන්න පුළුවන්ද මගේ cost එක කොච්චරක් වෙයිද revenue එක කොච්චරක්ද මොනවාද මගේ cost elements, what are my cost elements, how much should I get as a revenue, what is the cost per product, manufacturing cost. Likewise, you have to estimate, right? This is important, right? Okay. First of all, we'll see how the cost of a production is calculated, right? How to calculate a cost of your product, right? ඔයාගේ business එකේ ඔයා මොනහරි product එකක් නම් දෙන්නේ කොහොමද cost එක calculate කරන්නේ product එක? How to calculate the cost of a product, right? Okay. In every product, there are three cost elements, right? In every product, there are three cost elements, right? Mainly, what are they? Material cost, right? Is the wordings are visible? Liyana ya peena neda?
Peena sir.
Okay, right. Material cost, right? Material cost means the cost of the materials you purchased from outside, from your suppliers, right? Material cost, right? And labor cost, right? Material cost, labor cost, and overhead cost. So these are the three elements in every production cost. Where hammer, whatever the product you are producing, these are the main three cost elements. Right? Okay. Now, first you have to estimate what is the cost of the material to produce my product, right? Assume your product is a water bottle, right? So, before that, when we consider the cost, the term cost, right? There are two elements, right? One is operating cost, right? Operating cost, and other one is which we called as the fixed cost. So, one-time cost. One-time cost. So there are two kind of costs you incur, right? So what are the fixed costs associated in your businesses, right? What are the fixed costs associated in your businesses, right? So for an example, you have to buy a land, right? Land, cost of the land. It's a fixed cost, right? Because you are not incurring that expense more frequently. Hama tissiyame expense ekak daranne naha ne ekka parai ho depara, right? That is as an investment, right? Fixed cost, another name we can call it as an investment, right? Investments, because we are incurring these kind of cost in a very minimum, not frequently, but one transaction per year, only two. Likewise, mokada idam hemadama ganna ne idamak karagena hada, and the cost of the building. So if you purchase a building, the cost of that building, right? Not the rent, if you purchase, right? If you purchase the building, cost of that building. Or if you develop a building, building a khedwana, ek cost it, the cost of that building. So those are one-time cost, right? Those are not incurred frequently, right? And cost of vehicles, right? If you purchase a vehicle to your business, right? So cost of that vehicle is also the investment, right? Also the fixed cost, right? Because you don't purchase vehicles more frequently. Amadam vehicles ganne ekaparai ganne ho depa, right? Cost of vehicle. So that is the investment, fixed cost, one time cost, right? Another example, cost of machineries. If you buy a machine to your business, right? If you buy a machine to your business, so that is also the fixed cost, investment cost. So likewise, if you are not done any cost more frequently, or it's a one-time cost, that cost considered as the fixed cost, right? Why I am taking these two type of cost? Because these are the investments cost that you need to start your business. When calculating the cost of your product, these costs are irrelevant. These costs are not relevant, because you have to incur these costs when you start your business, right? Cost of machineries, cost of vehicles, and if you are rent your, if you got the building as a rent, you have to deposit a key money, right? That key money is also, because at the end of the renting period, that key money is also refunded to you, right? That key money is also one time cost, because it is not relevant to your manufacturing, right? Because it is not incurred, but you need to, that cost is needed to begin your business, right? Key money, right? These costs are not relevant to calculate the cost of your product, right? I will tell how these costs are relevant when calculating the product manufacturing cost, but the total cost of these expenses, so these investments, are not considered to calculate the cost of the product, right? Okay, then the operating costs are mainly material, labor, and overheads, right? Because these are the costs that are necessary to manufacture your product. These costs are more frequently incurred, right? You have to purchase monthly or weekly, right? You have to pay labor monthly. You have to incur your overhead cost, electricity, water, telephone, right? You have to incur several costs. These costs are essential to carry out your business, right? So that is why identify the difference between two cost elements, right? Fixed cost, investment and one-time cost, operating cost, material, labor and overheads. Right? Okay. Right. So to calculate the cost of your product, cost per unit, right? Wah, nishpadane karana mukak hari bandeka ek unit ekak tiyena cost ekak piriwaya kiyana. Right? So calculating a cost of the product, right? වට බොටල නිෂ්පාදනය කරන්න ඒක හොද කොස්ට එක් ගන්න ඔයා මොනාද අපිතමු ඔනහරි ජූස එකක්න හද ඒක කොස්ට එක කොහොමද ගන්න ඔයා අපිතමු සොෆ්ටය එකක්න හදන්න කොහොම දෙක කොස්ට එක ගන්න so likewise you have to think what are the cost related to my product right my business what are the cost elements right so every cost elements are coming under these three categories right okay first of all calculate the cost of product material cost right? material cost so you have to think where in your business what are the material මොනවාද අමුද්‍රව්‍ය මගේ මේ final output එක ගන්න මගේ final product එක ගන්න මොනවාද මට ඕන අමුද්‍රව්‍ය so you need to consider how much the material cost is going to incur to produce one unit of my product right so that cost per unit you have to calculate the cost per unit material cost per unit right material cost right assume this product needs two materials materials varga dekak kon right material a and material b right right material a and material b right so then you have to calculate how many how much or quantity how much the quantity that needs to that from the material a how much quantity that required to produce my ultimate product right so material a assume need 1 kilogram or 500 gram let's assume like that so if you are producing a cloth this is the material a means fabric or something like that right so need the 500 gram of cloth or fabric to produce that cloth right so material b need 100 gram right this is the units for to produce one specific cloth ek andumakata mecharak kon material a ekem 5 gram 500 gram material b ekem gram c right so then what is the cost per unit cost per unit me material ekak kiyeda kilogram ekak kiyeda right api idum kilogram ekak rupiyal 1000 right etakota metanne enne 0.5 kilogram metanne enne 0.1 kilogram right kilogram ekak rupiyal 1000 make material b ekek kilogram ekak rupiyal 500 then the total cost right then the total cost right units api idum kilograms walin enna kiyala right then arrive the total cost So the material cost of the product is 550 right so you are producing a cloth one specific cloth right so so the material cost of that product is 550 right then the labor right? Yeah, sure. You can take your break for the fasting. Right. No worry. Right. Now, then the labor. Right. So labor. So if you are employing a labor to your business, right, you have to calculate the salary that you paid to him or her for the calculation of unit cost, right? You are employing two laborers, right? Labor one, labor two. Right? And you paid 15,000 per month. Right? 15,000 per month. Right? 15,000 per month. So then you have to then estimate how much you are going to produce in, you have to estimate the, estimate your monthly production, right? If it is a water bottle, how much water bottle am I producing in this month, right? What is my monthly production? 5,000 units, 6,000 units. So that is my target, right? So that is my target, right? So assume to calculate this labor cost, you have two methods, right? The first method is this total salary divided by monthly production. Right? Assume you are expecting to produce 5,000 units per month. 5,000 units per month, then the cost is ₹3, right? If it is 5,000, you give these labors to a target, I need 5,000 production. ඔයා මේ ගන්න ටාගට් එකක් දෙනවා 5000ක් දුන්නොත් තමයි මේ 15000 දෙන්නේ right මට 5000ක ටාගට් එකක් අවර් කරන්න ඕන so I need 5000 production so that you are labor cost is ₹3 per unit right let's assume 500 right මට කෑලි 500ක් ඕන right so that ₹30 right 30 right this is the one method to calculate labor cost per unit right labor cost per manufacturing unit other method is if you are paying hourly salary where salary to gewanne hour walta na weda karana paya ganata ko karana weda anuwa na you have to take for if it is an garment if it is an cloth or garment how much of time you need to finish how much of time that employee spend to finish one garment right kochchara velawak yanawada employee ta ek garment ekak finish karana right assume 30 minutes right 30 minutes 30 minutes means 60 30 minutes means 0.5 hours. Bye bye again. Right? 0.5 hours. Right? Labor 2 ekkenata yanawa. Paya kala. Right? Ekenne 15 divided by 60. 0.25. Hours වලින් කිව්වොත් 0.25. Right? ඔයා මෙයා labor 1ට පැයකට ගෙවනවා 500ක්. Labor 2ට පැයකට ගෙවනවා 300ක්. Right? එතකොට cost එක calculate කරන්න මේ විදිහ. Right? Just I'm the don't consider about the figures, consider about the methods, right? Figures are you can estimate your figures, right? You know your business, so you know your cost, you know your material cost, you know how much you are willing to pay your labor, right? So this is another method, right? Based on the production or based on the time you can pay your labor. And the other thing is based on the monthly salary. And the monthly salary divided by the estimate monthly production. Right? So this is how you arrive the labor cost. Right? And then, so material cost, labor cost, and then the overhead cost. Right? Then the overhead cost. So what are the types of overhead cost? Right? What are the type of overhead cost? So these are the cost which are relevant and incurred day to day to manufacture your product or service other than the material and labor cost, right? Materials saha labors walata yanne nathi koi velet utpadane wena janane wena koi velet inka wena expense ekak tiyenawa na eka overhead walata yanne monada e wage expense, right? Electricity expense you need to your business, right? Water, telephone and internet. What are the other examples, right? So if you are occupying a rented building, right? So you have to pay rent, right? Rent expense, not the key money. This is the rent, 20,000, 30,000 per month, right? You have to pay more frequently. So the rent is the expense. It's the overhead cost. So you in your small factory, you occupied in the rent house, rented house. So the rent is the your expense, right? Rent. What are others? Stationaries, right? Stationaries. You need pen, pencils, half sheets, tea packs, various stationaries to them, right? Stationaries, right? What are others? You need there's a chat question called the advertisement. You can't get the advertisement here because you advertisements is not the manufacturing cost, right? Because you put an advertisement, it is an expense. It is an expense and it is not the fixed cost. It is an cost, but it is not incurred more frequently. You are not advertising your product more frequently, no? Right? So if you want to advertise, there's a specific period, right? That is not manufacturing cost. That is the marketing cost, right? We'll come to that, right? Advertisement is a separate thing, right? Right. Stationery is unique, right? What are others? Other cost. Yes, maintenance cost. Good. You have to maintain your vehicles, right? Vehicle maintenance cost. If you have a vehicle, you have to maintain. If you have a computers, computer maintenance cost. Right? If you have machines to manufacture your product, machine maintenance cost. Right? So any fixed assets you have and building maintenance cost, you have to maintain your building as well. No? Building maintenance cost. Right? So any fixed asset you have here, you have to maintain it, right? So you have to incur maintenance cost, right? Because these are directly related to your manufacturing of your product, right? What about fuel? Fuel for vehicle, right? If you purchase a generator, fuel for the generator, right? Fuel expense, right? What are other expenses? Yes. Any expense? You have to think what kind of expense that I am incurring for my business, right? Traveling. You have to travel, right? You have to daily travel to find suppliers, to any traveling, to find the suppliers, to meet customers. You have to travel. Any traveling expenses you can take, right? There's a question. Foods, no, foods you can't. Foods you cannot take because it is not directly involved to manufacturing of your production. Where foods ganna habai directly involved wenna ne meka manufacture karanne, right? Then see this electricity directly involved, water directly involved, telephone directly involved, right? Rent, you have to pay rent, directly involved. Stationery, directly involved to manufacture your vehicle, directly involved. Computer, directly involved, right? These are the costs you incur for the purpose of manufacturing that product, right? Foods, that is, you have to eat, no? Foods is a separate, right? That is not the, yeah.
මේ කම්පැනි එකෙන් වැඩ කරන අයට දෙනවා නම් කෑම එහෙම දවල්ට එහෙම කියලා.
එතකොට ගන්න ඕනේ. එතකොට ගන්න ඕනේ. ආ වා මෙන්ෂන් එකේ රේ ෆුඩ්ස්. ඒව ගන්න ඕනේ. රයිට්. So we can take the welfare for employees. Right? Welfare for employees. It is not only the foods, it is if you are providing a cloth to them, or if you are providing traveling to them, right? So that is, we can call the welfare to employees, right? What else? Right? So what you have to do is then first of all you have to list down your expenses, right, to relevant to manufacturing your product, right? You have to list down all the expenses that you are more frequently incur, right? හැම තිස්සෙම incur වෙන expenses or list down කරගෙන යන්න, right? Then you have to estimate how much of electricity, how much of expense that incurred per month, right? Based on your surveys or internet, කොච්චර electricity bill එක ඇයිද මේක මට මේ units 500ක් manufacture කරන්න අපි 500 න ගත්තේ unit 500ක් මාසයකට ගහන්න නම් කොච්චර electricity expense එකක් ඇයිද. So you have to estimate how much electricity expense incurred per month to manufacture 500 unit. Assume 5,000, right? Water 3,000. So you have to be estimate. You have to estimate in a logical manner, right? Kochchara unit gana kiyaida meka nishpadane karanna unit ekak rate ekak kiyeda eken wedi kala ganna puluwan, right? How much of units, how much of kilowatts that we will spend to manufacture the final product and multiplied by the unit rate, right? And the water, same thing. Telephone, same thing. Assume 2,000. Rent you know, no? Monthly rent you know, 20,000, right? Stationaries, you can assume a figure, right? 2,500 per month, right? Telephone tag padi karam 5,000. Vehicle maintenance cost, how much would be the vehicle maintenance cost? You have to do the services and you have to do the repairs likewise. So let's assume 50,000 per na 10,000 per month, right? Vehicle maintenance cost, computer maintenance cost 5,000 per month, machine maintenance cost 3,500 per month. You have to assume, right? Kochchara kya ide, maybe building maintenance cost 1,500 per month, right? Fuel, how much the cost of fuel per month? 15,000 or 10,000, right? You have to assume. Well, traveling, you have to assume 5,000 per month. Welfare for employees, how much cost for how much cost incurred for foods? There are if you are paying an EPF ETF, there are EPF ETF and bonuses, all the things you have to include there. EPF, EDF, bonuses. If you are giving a traveling to them, that's the traveling charge. All the things you are incurred. Assume 5,000 per month, right? Likewise, you have to estimate every cost item. How much would be the cost per month, right? Then you can take the total. And your monthly production is 500 units, right? Divided by that amount. Total cost divided by that amount, right? So unit overhead cost per unit is 149, right? Divided by monthly production. Overhead cost divided by monthly production, right? $70, right? This is the total. right? 74,500 divided by 500, 149. Right, now you can get the total cost per unit, right? First of all, we have to check what is the material cost, right? We'll take a separate sheet, right? Material cost, right? Right. So this is the cost chart, right? Cost sheet per unit, right? Material A. What is the cost? Material cost. Material A is total cost is 500, right? 500. Material B, right? Material B total cost is 50. Right, so total 550 material cost, then labor, right, we are discussing the cost per unit sheet. Now screen is visible or no? Excel is visible, no? Right, material, now labor 1 250, labor 2 75, right? So total labor cost per unit. Ekka unit ekara total labor cost ekak kiyen. 325. Material cost ekak 550. And the overhead cost. Right? Overhead cost is 149. Then total cost per unit is accumulation of material, labor and overhead, right? Material, labor and overhead, right? 1024. This is the total cost per unit, right? Understood how to calculate the material cost, right? So this is the material cost per unit, your cost, right? Why this cost? Now any questions regarding the cost calculation? Any unclear area? So you have to think in your business, how can I ascertain, how can I gain the cost per unit in my product, right? What are my materials? What am I employing a labor, right? And what are my overhead costs, right? These are the few examples. So you, in your business, the examples are different, but these things are definitely come, right? If you are purchasing a vehicle, if you are that vehicle maintenance cost, definitely come. If you are using a computer, the computer maintenance cost definitely come, right? Machine maintenance cost definitely come. Building maintenance cost definitely come, right? So then you have to estimate what is the cost per month, right? These are the rough estimates, right? So once you start your business, and then you can come up with the actual figures. So these are the just rough exam, rough estimate, how much would I incur? Right? Any questions up to now? Any question, please ask.
Sir, labor cost එක පොඩ්ඩක් ආපහු කියලා දෙන්නකෝ.
Right. Okay. So, මේ labor cost එක එන්නේ ඔයා ඔයාගේ business එකට කවුරු හරි labor කෙනෙක් හරි employee කෙනෙක් හරි ගන්නවා නම් විතර. නැත්තම් ඔයාට මේ ඔයාගේ cost එකක් දාගන්න ඕනේ නැහැ මෙතන. ඔයා විතරක් නම් ඉන්නේ දැනට ඔයාගේ business එකට. එතකොට labor cost එකක් ඉන්නේ. ඔයා බලාපොරොත්තු වෙනවා නම් කවුරු හරි labor කෙනෙක් හරි employee කෙනෙක් හරි ගන්න ආගේ business එකට. එතකොට තමයි මේ labor cost එක එන්නේ. Right? So the labor cost, there are two ways to calculate this labor cost. One method is, once you hire a labor, ඔයා labor කෙනෙක් ගත්තොත් ඔයාගේ business එකට, ඔයා එයාට monthly salary එකක් ගෙවනවා. Right? If you are pay a monthly salary to that labor, that monthly salary divided by the monthly production. Oya meya dannawa 15000 dila oya kiyena hari mata andum 500ක් මාසෙට මහලා දෙන්න. Right? So your monthly production is 500. So that unit cost per that labor is 30 rupees. තොඩ එක ඇඳුමකට හරි එක මොකක් හරි වාගේ ප්‍රොඩක්ෂන් හේකට හරි කෝස්ට් එක 12 30. This is the one method. If you are pay monthly salary to them. But some laborers, they are paying a daily or month hourly salary. Right? Or daily salary. Right? For an example, if it is a garment, එක ඇඳුමක් නම් ඒ ඇඳුම මහන්න ඒ ලේබර්ට යනවා පැය භාගයක්. Right? ඔයා පැයකට ඒ ලේබර්ට ගෙවනවා රුපියල් 500. පැයකට ගෙවනවා 500. Right? එතකොට ඒ ලේබර්ගේ කොස්ට් එක වෙන්නේ ඒ ඇඳුම මහන්න එයාට යනවා පැය භාගයක්. ඔයා පැයකට 500ක් ගෙවනවා. එතකොට එයාගේ කෝස්ට් එක වෙන්නේ රුපියල් 250. මොකද ඒ ඇඳුමට ඒ ලේබර්ට පැය භාගයක් යනවා. ඔයා දැන් 500ක් පැයකට ගෙවනවා. එතකොට එයාගේ කෝස්ට් එක වෙන්නේ 250. Right? Mathematics තියෙන එක. It's a mathematics, right? You hire a labor and you estimate that that labor require half an hour complete that product, right? So you pay 500 per hour, so then the cost is 250. Simple mathematics, right? Labor 2 same, right? A labor ta yanawa pay kala e wede karanne oya pay ekata 300ක් ගෙවන්න. එතකොට එක garment එකක් හරි එක production එකකට 75 rupees යනවා a labor cost එක. 75 rupees, right? And එතකොට තමයි මේ 325 in, right? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. Thank Any questions? There's a chat question. If we have 100 labels, oh, do we have to multiply? Yes, yes, yes. Sir. Yes, yeah. If you... don't get confused, na? If you have 100 labors, you don't need to multiply it into 100 because we are calculating the cost per unit. Oya employees la 100ක් හිටියත් 200ක් හිටියත් ඔයා මෙතන කැල්කියුලේට් කරන්නේ එක යුනිට් එකක cost එක. Right? එතකොට what employees la 100ක් හිටියොත් right එතකොට ඔයා බලන්න ඕනේ මෙහෙම එකක් බලන්න ඕනේ ආව් අවතනවා කියන එක හරි එතකොට labor 1 labor 2 labor 3 100 labors වා දාන්න ඕන ඔව් ඔයා කියන එක හරි right 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 if you have 100 labors yes you have to do this labor 3 4 5 6 7 8 right that's okay that's yes yes if you are if you have 100 labors you have to do like that right if it is if you need 5 materials you need material a b c d and e d f any kind of cost if you incur you have to take right that's a good question yes employees la 100ක් හිටියත් 1 by 1 1 by 1 1 by 1 cost එක ගන්නවා එක employee ට 10000ක්ද ගෙවන්නේ එයා කොච්චර monthly production එක කියේ 20000ක්ද ගෙවන්නේ monthly production එක කියේද බෙදන්න නැත්තම් අර අවලි ක්‍රමයට ගෙවනවා නම් මේ විදිහට right okay that's a good question right any questions any questions more questions you will clear very easily right okay right why this figure is important ai me unit cost ek important right because if you need to earn a profit right if you need to earn a profit you have an idea about the cost the cost number how much would be the cost of my product oyata profit ekak ganna na oyage oluwe tiyennone oyage product ekage cost ekak kiyeda kiyala that is why this number is important right then I can add my profit margin so that I can net yes I need a 20% profit margin 20% profit right so I add the 20% 20% right so this is my price this is my selling price right මම 120ක ලාභයක් තියාගෙන selling price එක දෙනවා right this is my selling price for to arrive to get your selling price first of all you need to get your cost per unit right then only you can fix your selling price or you can fix your discounts right so you can give discounts to 0 to 5% or 7% to your customers right මොකද ඔයාගේ profit margin එක ඔයා හිතනවා 20% වත් තිබ්බා තියෙනවා ඒතකොට මට customers ලට 7ක් 6ක් 5ක් වගේ discount එකක් දෙන්න පුළුවන් to determine the discount rate to determine the profit margin to determine the price selling price that is why this cost per unit is important right mokada oya cost ekak dannawana oya oata puluwan ona patthakata karakawanna right price ekak wedi karanna puluwan podi profit ekak thiyagena mikunanna puluwan competitors lage price analyze karala balla business ekak patan gannakota podi profit margin ekak thiyela market ekata danna puluwan etara price ekak adu wenawa right so assume you are competitor the same product your competitor selling at 1190 rupees right so then you can minimize your profit margin you can add 10% because you are new to this market right you are starting your fresh business right then just add 10% then you can sell it 1126 right so you can compare your price with the competitor's price how much the competitor's price and then you can adjust you are profit margin, right? First year, yes, you have to gain the market, right? First year ke oya kohomari market ekak allanne. So price ekak adu karala deela kohomari market ekak allanne balanna. Right? So you compare the competitors' price and adjust your price according, your profit margin according. Right? For that, you have an idea about the cost. What is the cost of my product? Right? That is why this cost element is important. Right? Understood? Any questions? Any questions? Right. Now, I am giving, I hope you all are now have a business idea and what is the product that you are going to produce. Business plan එක පටන් ගත්තද වැඩි? Hope you have a business idea now. What is the product that you are going to offer, right? So from today onwards, you can assess what are my cost elements, right? What are my material cost? If I am hiring a labor, how much labor should I want? And what is the price? What is the labor rate? Or what is the salary that I am paying? What are my overhead costs? And what are the what is the overhead cost per month? So likewise, first of all, you have to ascertain your manufacturing cost, right? So that is the thing, right? Okay. So this is how to calculate the cost of product, right? So then we'll move to the profit calculation. Right? Profit calculation. How to calculate the profit. Okay. To calculate the profit, hope you remember there are different kind of formats, right? So you can refer any format, but you have to at final result should be the profit. Any format you can use, final result should be the profit, right? First of all, you have to calculate the revenue, right? You have to calculate the revenue. Then these cost elements, right? Material cost. Material cost. Labor cost. Overhead cost. Right? Revenue, material, labor, overhead cost. Right? Then so the total of these three cost elements will be called as a production cost. Right? Production cost. Right? If you divided the revenue from the production, if you subtract revenue එකෙන් production cost එක අඩු කරාම එනවා අපි එකට කියනවා cost of sale. මම figures අරන් කියන්න කොහොමද derive වෙන්නේ කියලා මම මුලින්ම format එක කියගෙන I will describe with the figures. First of all, I will list down the format first, right? the cost of sale, right? Then the gross profit. Right? Sorry, cost of sales means this is the separate concept. So gross profit is revenue subtracted by the cost of sale. It's come to the gross profit, right? You will understood very well when I am describing with the figures, right? Then there are some operating costs. Yes. We can call this as administration cost. Administration cost and marketing cost. Finance administration, marketing, finance cost. Then the profit cost, the net profit, right? Right. So this is the format basically, right? Revenue, material cost, labor, production cost, then the cost of sale, gross profit, administration cost, marketing cost, finance cost, net profit, right? So this is the basically the basically a form, right? Right. Okay. Assume, right? First year, year one, right? Hope you remember. You have. I told that you have to prepare this for at least for 5 years, right? Hope you remember that, right? So year two, year three, year four, year five. And the total cost, right? So you have to keep in mind you have to produce this at least for 5 years, right? Okay. Then the revenue, right? So in here, so these are all figures, are all are estimates, right? Revenue means how much the, now in this example, your monthly production is 500, right? Your monthly production is 500, right? So then the annual production is, right? So monthly production, this example, monthly production is 500, right? So the annual production is
500 multiplied by 12,
right? This 500 multiplied by 12, 6,000, right? Assume you are able to solve 80% of this production. මේ 6000න් 80% විතර විකුණ ගන්න පුළුවන් වෙනවා. පුළුවන් වෙනවා කියලා assume කරනවා first. ආ නෑ 80% නෙමෙයි. පිටමු 60% වගේ විතර විකුණ ගන්න පුළුවන් කියලා හිතනවා. Right? First year. So 6000 into 60%. Right, 3,600. What we could have done, right? Without a pay selling price, second year, the egg does a CVC, right? So our revenue come from expected sales quantity multiplied by price, selling price. එතකොට ඊය වන් එකේ අපේ රෙවෙනියු එක වෙන්නේ 3600 වැඩි කරනවා සෙලින් ප්‍රයිස් එක multiplied by right okay. So this is the revenue. අපි 3600යි විකුණනවා කියලා එස්ටිම හිතුව. කියන අපිට තිබෙන මාකට් ඉන්ෆෝමේෂන් අනුව කස්ටමර්ස්ලා අනුව so that is why the customer planning is important right so Patrinza will discuss about the customer aspect how to identify your customers so you have to gain an understanding about your customers what is the market size so that you estimate that yes even though I am producing 6000 unit but I have to sell around 3600 right මොකද නිෂ්පාදනය කරන හැම එකම විකිනවයි කියලා අපිට estimate කරන්න බෑ සමහර වෙලාවට පුළුවන් වෙයි අපි දන්නේ නැහැ මොනවාද වෙන්නේ කියලා right but normally if you within the first year you are just start your business right then only your revenue is increased okay. So the first year revenue is 4 million around 4 million right then the material cost right you now you have the material cost right 550 right so in here when you are calculating the material cost you have to take the cost of the selling items right oya me 6000 ta ne me cost ekak ganni den mokada metana api gatte 3600 ne api vikka 3600 oya ga stock ekak tiyana 2400 oya eke ilanga avuruddhe vikunana right mokada ilanga avuruddhe oya ga stock ekak tiyana 2400 එතකොට ඊළඟ අවුරුද්දේ ඔයා හිතනවා ඩිමාන්ඩ් එක 4000ක් වෙයි කියලා. එතකොට ඔයාලට ඒ අනුව ප්‍රොඩක්ෂන් එක plan කරගන්න පුළුවන්. right? මොකද දැන් එතකොට දැන් material cost එක ඔයා ගන්නේ ඔයා ගන්න material cost එක 550. අපි මේ A and B දෙකම එකතු කරලා ගත්තොත් 550 into 3600. right? Right. So that is the material cost. Right. Danne vikinichcha pramanayata tamai cost ekak danne. Mokada api metanath gatte vikinichcha pramanaya. Ekotta material cost equal to expected sales quantity into cost per material cost per unit the unit cost per material cost material cost per unit right material cost per unit right ඕනනම් එක මේ material cost A and B කියලා separately දාන්නත් පුළුවන්. මම මේකටම දැම්. right? Then labor. Labor එක right? 325 into 3600 නේ නිෂ්පාදනය කරපු ඒවා එමිකුනේ. right? Oh, 600. Right? මේ ගානේ 1.1 million. Right? then the overhead cost, right? So this overhead cost, so the we have a list of items now, so you can take one by one, it is your prefer. I take the total one, eh? So you can take the one by one electricity, this is, so you can divide it by 500, right? So this is 500 500, right? So if you want, right, you can take one by one the cost element, right? If you divide by this, then right, right? So the total is 149, right? So you can take 10 6 10 40 40, likewise item by item you can take if you want, right? So I will take 149, right? Overhead cost, right? 149 into $3,600, right? So that is the overhead cost, right? So then I'll put this into this column. Then the total production cost is, total production cost is this, right? So same as the labor cost, expected sales quantity into labor cost per unit, expected sales cost multiplied by labor cost per unit, overhead cost, expected sales quantity multiplied by overhead cost per unit, right? Then you take the total production cost. Then this revenue deducted by production cost, sorry, cost of sale is the same figure of the your production cost, right? Why this may production cost එකයි cost of sale එකයි same වෙන්නේ එතන ඇවිල්ලා accounting someone mic is on, right? Okay, right. So why that are you all there?
Yes sir.
Connection ek me unne ne, right? Okay, right. මේ ප්‍රොඩක්ෂන් කොස්ට් එකයි කොස්ට් ඔෆ් සේල් එකයි කියන්නේ එකම ෆිගර් එක එන්නේ, හැබැයි මේ ටර්ම්ස් දෙකක්. ඒක දැනට මොකද මේක කියලා දෙන්න ගියාම ඕගොල්ලන්ට පැටලුනොත් මේ වෙනවා. දැන් from time being just assume this production cost is equal to the cost of sale, right? Why I will showcase the difference, right? Production cost means, right, production cost means the cost of your total production, right? If you are to see your total production is 6,000, right? Right. So what is the material cost, labor and overhead, right? Total cost is 124, right? 124. When we multiplied that, right? Around 6 million, 6.1 million, right? But you sold only 3,600, right? You sold only 3,600, right? So there, that means you have a inventory, waga inventory thiyena stock vela thiyena 2,400, right? So value of this 2,400, right, is 2.4 million, right? So if you subtract total production cost in the inventory, then the same figure is come, right? See, same figure is come. This is we called the cost of sale, right? Cost of the selling item, right? So time being, so total production cost is 6.1 million, but I included, but I got the selling, only the selling, I consider the only selling cost in this format, right? This is how the, this is the difference between the production cost and the cost of sale, right? In the production cost, we consider the total cost, right? In the cost of sale, we only consider the cost of selling items, right? That means total manufacturing quantity subtracted by the inventory, right? අපි 6000ක් manufacture කරා 3600යි විකුණුවේ 2400ක් අපේ inventory තියෙනවා, right? එතකොට අපි manufacturing cost එකේ inventory වල cost එක අඩු කරාම තමයි එන්නේ cost of sale, right? ඒක තමයි මේ cost එක, right? ඒක තමයි මේක, right? So the cost of sale means, cost of sales means there are two ways to calculate cost of sales. Selling quantity multiplied by cost per unit, right? Other method is total production cost subtracted by total production cost plus opening inventory minus closing in, right? I mean opening inventory enne oya ilaga avuruddata yanawata wage me inventory opening inventory enne etoka cost of sale walata total production cost ekata opening inventory wala cost ekata ekathu kala closing inventory adu karama thamai meke enne, right? Dan metana opening inventory ekak nathi hinda thamai opening inventory zero etoka closing stock ekak adu karama meke ena kiyala, right? So that is the different production cost and the cost of sale, right? Then the gross profit. Gross profit means revenue subtracted by cost of sale, right? So this is the gross profit, right? This is the gross profit. Right? Up to now clear? Any questions? Up to now all clear. Then there are another cost elements: administration cost, marketing cost, finance cost, right? right? What are these administration costs, right? So if you are recruiting, right, recruiting an office staff, not for the directly to the manufacturing, right? Oya office ekey mona hari me accounts hadanna hari oya mona hari office ekey weda walata pn genek hari gattot eyaage salary ekiyanne me administration cost kiyana category ara product ekak directly hadanna ganna employees la nemei me right if you hire an employee to manufacture your product directly, that cost go to the labor cost. But if you hire an employee to do the office work, right, accounting, if you hire a lawyer, if you hire a engineer, no, if you hire a lawyer, or if you hire an accountant, or if you hire a clerk, right, PN, right, and any any තව කවුරු හරි ඔය chef or anyhow any employee who is not directly involved to the manufacture of the production product who is not directly involved to the manufacturing process that costs come to the administration cost category right employees la gannawana manufacture directly manufacturing nowana anikut karyan sandaha egulanta giyana salary ek kelim administration cost kela ganna saha if you are an open a current account oya current account ek open karana toyata ena check oyata puluwa check book bagata right so that they have charged the bank charges right එතකොට ඒ එක එක බෑන්ක් චාර්ජස් ගහනවා ඔයාගේ account එක. So they have charges several bank charges. That cost is also included in this administration cost. Right? That cost is also included in this administration cost. So the concept, the difference between administration cost and the production cost is if you are incurring any cost indirectly or for the office purposes those costs are included in the administration cost da udaharana kelita mehema gannako oya building dekak ganna eka building ma podi space ekak gannawa office ekata oya office space ekata thawa building ak gannawa eke thamai oya product එක manufacture කරන්නේ. ඒකේ තමයි factory තියෙන්නේ පොඩි. Right? එතකොට අර factory තියෙන building එකේ water, electricity, තවමනාද telephone, මේ factory තියෙන building එකේ building maintenance ඔක්කොම යන්නේ මේ production overhead එකට. production cost එක overhead. හැබැයි ඔයා building එකක් ගත්තොත් ඔයාගේ office purpose එකට not the manufacturing purpose. ඔයාගේ office එක maintain කරන building එකක් ගත්තොත් ඒක යන්නේ ඒකේ cost එක යන්නේ මේ administration cost. Right? That is the difference. So like the marketing cost the same thing. That advertisement cost the someone said advertisement called in the chat. That advertisement cost comes under this marketing cost, right? Because those are not directly involved to the manufacturing of your product. Those are cost incurred for the marketing your product, right? So that is the coming under the marketing cost, advertisement cost, and. If you sell on credit basis to your customers or nayata vikrana customers right so then the customers are not paying customers are ogalanta gewanne was so it was your customers lada option ekak dena you gave an option to the customer if you pay within another 2 weeks time right if you pay my credit in another 2 weeks time I will give a discount right ඔයාට රුපියල් 5000ක වටිනාකම ලැබෙන දින කස්ටමර් එක. දැන් කස්ටමර් ගෙවලා නැහැ. ඊට පස්සේ ඔයා කියන කස්ටමර්ට ඔයා මේ 5000 මට ඉදිරි සති දෙක ඇතුළත ගෙවුවොත් මම ඔයාට 105ක වට්ටමක් දෙනවා. ඒතකොට ඔයා මට ගෙවන්න ඕනේ 5500 4750 105ක වට්ටමක් දෙනවා. So that you are incurred 250 expense right otherwise discount එක ඔයාගේ වියදමවා ඔයා රික්මට සල්ලි ගන්න ඕනවට ඔයා කියන හරි මට 100 මම ඔයාට 105ක වට්ටමක් දෙනවා ඔයා මට මේක දුන්නා right so you are expensing 250 expense that expense is also the marketing cost right so that is another example advertisement cost is another example right for an example if you are a hire a labor to sell this product he is not manufacturing this product so you are you handing over to your employee and he is responsible to sell your product the salary that paid to that guy is also the marketing cost because he only involved to the marketing selling the product not the manufacturing product right so basically if any cost incurred right to manufacture your product that cost comes under the production cost if any cost incurred other than manufacturing your product right for administrative services or for marketing services right if any cost incurred for administration purpose marketing purpose that cost should recorded under the administration cost and the marketing cost right so those are the administration and marketing cost any unclear area any questions Any questions? All clear. Any questions up to now? Right. Okay. Right. Then. Right. Before moving to the finance cost, we'll take a 10-minute break. And I will then explain the finance cost to you, right? What is the finance cost? And we'll come to the net profit, right? Okay. So the time is 7:24. We'll come on to the 7:34, right? I will, don't worry, I will share this Excel and then you can, you can utilize this Excel to your business plan as well and get all the idea right don't worry okay
hello right. sir
okay right now you know the revenue how to get the revenue material labor and overhead cost right and the difference between administration marketing cost and the production cost right whatever the cost that incurred which are directly incurred for manufacturing of your product that cost is going to the production cost if it is not directly involved to the manufacturing of the product if it is involved to the administration purpose if it is involved to the marketing purpose then that cost go to the administration and marketing side then the finance cost right finance cost means if you are obtain a loan bank loan or lease right from the bank then you have to pay the interest, right? That interest should record it in the finance cost, right? You have to estimate what is the interest expense for my business in first year, interest expense, right? So what is the marketing cost for the first year? What is the administration cost for the first year? So for likewise, you have to estimate, right? So the finance cost is basically the interest you paid for the bank, for your bank loan or the lease you obtained, right? So that is basically the finance cost, right? So that, so we'll make some figures. 52,000, marketing cost 60,000, finance cost 80,000, right? So then we and take the cost here. And then our net profit is gross profit subtracted by the administration, total of administration, marketing and finance cost. So our gross profit is 176,000. So this is our gross profit. So sorry, our net profit is 176,000. Right, net profit and the gross profit, right? So this is the basically how to calculate your profit of your business, right? So same thing continue in the year two as well, right? Same thing continue. What is the revenue? Total expected sales quantity into sales price, and what will be the material cost? So you can adjust the material cost because basically in when you go to the year two, your material cost should increase, no? So you can adjust your material cost there. Like we have inflation rate, no? Uddaman anupate thiyenne. E anupate balagena wedi karala danna. Just estimate, no? These are estimate figures, right? So likewise, labor rate. The apply that rate into the labor rate, year two, right? Year three apply that, year four apply that. Likewise, you have to increase your cost because cost is always increased. No, this year cost is not in the next year, right? Net profit ekak gatte kohomada? Net profit ekak gatte me gross profit ekak thiyenawane api gawa, right? Net profit එක ගත්තේ gross profit divided by sorry subtracted by total of admin plus marketing plus finance cost. Gross profit take gatte hima me net profit take gatte hima, right? Gross profit take me thune ekathu adu kara, right? Gross profit minus admin cost plus marketing cost plus finance cost, right? Ema net profit take gan, right? So this is basically a how to calculate your profit, right? So year 2, right? Assume you are producing 4,000, right? Year 2 you are producing 4,000 and you have a 2,400 stock, right? From year 1 you have 2,400 stock, right? So then you have around 6,400 units in year 2, right? This is year 1. Year 2 එකේ අපි හිතමු ඔයාලට 70%ක් විකුණ ගන්න පුළුවන්. Right? එතකොට ඔයා විකුණන්නේ or the RSC also. So same thing applied here. Same thing applied here. So when you go to the material cost, you can increase that material cost, because when it's come to the year two, increase certain percentage, right? I recommended to use the inflation rate, right? If it is the Sri Lanka inflation rate is 5%, then multiply your material cost by 5%, right? Labor cost, overhead cost, likewise, you can multiply it by 5%, right? Same thing, you have to continue, right? So the you have to apply the same selling quantity, right? So year two, you have to fill like that. Year three, you have to fill like that. Year four, you have to fill like that. And year five, then the total is the total of year one, year two, year three, year four, year five. Okay. So that is how you calculate in the profit. So these are the two things that you need to present in the financial plan, in your business plan, right? What is the cost of your product, and what is the revenue, what is the price of your product, and what is the profit, right? So this is the two things that you need to present to your business, right? Any questions? Any questions? Please ask. Any questions? Any questions in the business plan? If you are already started your business plan, any questions? Right. So if you have any questions, please email to me. Yeah. So then I can give my view. Anytime you can email to me. It doesn't matter, Patrina sir is continuing, you can ask any questions to me, right? Doesn't matter, I will respond, right? Any questions, please ask, right? Okay, this is basically how you need to do your financial plan, right? Hope it is clear. No questions in the chat. So basically, right, that is the financial plan, right? Okay, right. So that will be the end of the first session. Then I will, since this is the last, not the last, I'm delivering the lecture because from next week onwards, you will have the Patiran sir will continue the balance part. So I will recap what I done so far, then you will get an understand, then you will get an understand in a broader way, right? I will recap what we'll do up to now, these four sessions, right? Okay. Let me stop share this. Right. In session one, we discuss about the introductory part of the entrepreneur, right? So we first, I hope you remember, we first, very first session, we build definition for the entrepreneur, right? So we build entrepreneur means bear of a risk, right? Planning, organizing, a little bit of management part, resource management, right? Yeah. It's not a job, it is entrepreneur is not doing a job because he is the founder of the that company, right? We'll develop an entrepreneur definition, right? So then we'll come to the definition. He's a person, entrepreneur is a person who creates a new business in the face of risk and uncertainty for the purpose of achieving profit and growth by identifying significant opportunities and assembling the necessary resources to capitalize on them, right? So what is the basic, what are the highlight words? New business, entrepreneur always started a new business, entrepreneur take risk, he combined resources and he faced uncertainty, right? These are the highlighted words in the entrepreneur, right? Right. Then we discuss the concept of entrepreneurship, right? Entrepreneurship, as I said, it is a skill that entrepreneur has, right? Entrepreneur should have the entrepreneurship skill that entrepreneur have. Entrepreneur is the one who doing that. So the skill that entrepreneur has is the entrepreneurship, right? Okay. Right, we discussed the definitions of the entrepreneurship, and then we discussed the model, right? How this entrepreneur combine the resources, the opportunity, right? And the, his entrepreneurship. So the output from this combination is what? The output of this combination is the novelty product, new business idea, right? To new business idea to the market. That is the output, right? And then we discuss the difference between entrepreneur and the entrepreneurship, right? We discuss the difference. See, the entrepreneur is the person, one who doing that, and the entrepreneurship is the skill, right? How he doing that, how he, the way, the method he doing that, right? Okay, so the entrepreneur is the person, entrepreneurship is always talking about the procedure, process, the method, the activities, right? Entrepreneur is always talk about the individual person, right? Entrepreneurship is always talking about the process, activity, right? Then we talk about the entrepreneurship, right? So hope you remember the entrepreneur is the one who innovate within an organization, right? So entrepreneur does not take the risk as much as take by the entrepreneur, right? Both are do the same job, but the entrepreneur innovate within his business because he is an employee of that business, entrepreneur, right? He take the salary through his entrepreneurship skill. He can share a profit for his novelty product, right? If the high management approve his product, then he can share a profit from his product, from the selling of his product, right? So we talk features, we talk about, and we discuss the difference between entrepreneurship and the entrepreneurship, right? So always the risk is entrepreneur take the lower risk than the entrepreneur, right? And then we discuss the personal entrepreneur characteristics. Hope you remember the 7 P's, right? Pattern, passion. We discuss this Lassana Flora example, right? His passion, his pattern, right? His pattern of identifying opportunities, right? And the fearless character of Mr. Anathung, passion, right? So how he behave in 1995, 1996, right? How he save our great cricket legend. That's a passionate. That's a passion we need from the entrepreneur, right? Principles we talk about, right? How the Mataram, Odiri Silva principles, right? In doing his business. People, right? How the importance of networking and collaboration for the entrepreneur we discuss, because the networking is very important for the entrepreneur, right? And we perseverance, how we come out with the total disaster of the tsunami, right? The Sanchi Jadi at Coastguard, how we develop his business after the tsunami, right? We discuss perseverance. And the progress, right? Right. The entrepreneur, the main path to success is the experience of entrepreneurs, right? Experience is key for the entrepreneur, right? So career path, we discussed they have two kind of career path. One are go to the universities and others are go to the directly go to the job market, and they gain the tacit knowledge and the university guys get the explicit knowledge. We discussed, right, how we going to build this business, right? And we talk about the positives and negatives about being an entrepreneur, right? And some terms, incubator, venture capitalist, we talk about who is the incubator, right? The person, more the consultancy firms, we called as most of the incubators, right? Venture capitalist firms, the firms who give financials to the entrepreneurs, right? So we talk about the venture capitalists, right? And we discuss about few examples, how a person become entrepreneur, right? So entrepreneur should bear a risk and the uncertainty. We talk about few examples, right? The importance of the entrepreneurship, because he create a job, he improve the product, he improve the quality of the product, right? He provide the economic development, he contribute for the economic development, right? And then the difference between the entrepreneur and the manager, right? Few differences, right? And then types of entrepreneurs, what are the types, right? We discuss various things, right? And the factors that affect into entrepreneurial growth, right? What are the factors? Motivational factors specifically, right? Desire to independence control, family tradition. These are the motivation factors that affect into person, that affect into a person to become an entrepreneur, right? Improve the social status, passion to innovate and create new products, strategy to counter discrimination as an alternate, limited opportunity for career advance. Likewise, we discuss several motivation factors, right? And we gave certain questions for your assignments, right? So this is the first session that we discussed. Basically, we covered the introductory part, right? And in the next session, we'll discuss the entrepreneurial process, right? Right? We discuss the entrepreneurial process, right? Opportunity recognition and the idea, and then the execution come, right? So difference between idea and opportunity, we discuss the methods of opportunity opportunity identification, how to identify your opportunities, right? So through prior knowledge, cognitive factors, social networks, right? Economic factor, economic forces, social forces, technological forces, political forces, right? So how to get the business ideas, right? So then we come to the business plan, right? That is your assignment, right? Human resource plan, right? Product and service, we discussed how to get human resource plan, operational plan, right? What are the resources? Means there are three aspects: economic, operational, and tangibility, right? Management of the enterprise team, right? And we discussed the team and model, right? So basically, we covered the entrepreneurial process with a lot of theories, right? Okay. Then we discuss about the feasibility study, I think. Yeah. Hope you remember we discussed about the feasibility study, right? Right. So when to conduct the feasibility study is to check whether your business idea is commercially viable or not, right? So in this stage, you doing the feasibility study, right? So in the feasibility study, there are four types: product and service feasibility, industry and market feasibility, organizational feasibility, financial feasibility, right? So these are the four types of feasibility. And how to conduct a feasibility study, right? Product and service, it is, first of all, you have to prepare a survey or questionnaire and then give to the customers. Then you get an idea about your product and service, right? And then, so you can get the customer suggestion, their like and dislike about your product, right? Their suggestions for improvement, right? And then the market feasibility. So you are identify the your market, your competitors, your industry, right? The few checklists you have to fill, right? Right, market feasibility, organizational feasibility, right? Management power, resources sufficiency, right? How to assess yourself, your strength and weaknesses, right? How to assess yourself, resources sufficiency, assessing your resources, right? Few checklists I was given, right? To assess your resources, right? And then the financial feasibility, the startup cost, the capital cost you need to start your business, right? So basically that is the feasibility study, right? And then we discuss several entry wedges to the business. Hope you remember, right? Entry, how you can start your business, right? What are the methods? We discuss about the market, several strategies: market penetration, product development, market development, diversification, right? Market penetration means existing product in the existing market, right? Same product in the same market, right? Product development means new product to the existing market. For your existing market, you are producing a new product. Market development means new market for the existing product, right? So you are, if you are planning to export, that is the market development, right? Diversification, new product to a new market. You export new product to the, you innovate and manufacture new product and you export. That is called the diversification. New product, new market, right? Market penetration, market developments, product development, diversification. And we discussed the franchising. Hope you remember the example of McDonald's, KFC, Domino's, Pizza Hut. Those are the examples for franchising business, right? Ownership types, right? We discussed about the sole proprietorship, partnership, limited liability companies, right? How you can start your business in a sole proprietorship, partnership, right? Advantages and disadvantages we discussed, right? And so basically that are the entry wedges to the business, right? Then we move to the vision and mission. Hope you remember. Because in your business plan, under the business description, you have to write your business vision and the business mission, right? So we discuss what is the vision, right? This is a long-term dream, right? The characteristic of a vision should be a futuristic one and the long-term dream, right? And what are the questions that you need to ask when you develop in a vision to your business, right? Characteristics of a good vision, right? And the mission, the present situation of your business, right? What is you are currently doing at the moment, what is you are doing right now, right? Characteristic of the mission, right? And the difference between vision and mission we discussed, right? And we discussed few examples, Toyota, Ford, Coca-Cola mission and vision, right? And then we comes to the objectives, right? I told that objective should be SMART, specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time bound, right? Should be SMART. In your business, you have to establish and SMART objectives, right? So two broad types, financial objectives and strategic objectives, right? Financial objectives are in the financial terms. Strategic objectives mainly focus on the market share, right? Improve the market share, right? So I gave the several examples, examples for the financial objectives, examples for the strategic objectives, right? Several examples, right? So then after that, so we discuss about the business environment, right? Right. We discuss about the business environment, right? So why you need to analyze the business environment? Because you need to identify your strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats, right? That is why you need to analyze the business environment, right? In your business, you need to analyze your business environment because you have to do the SWOT analysis. Strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats, right? So why you need to identify the strength, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. That is the purpose of doing this, right? And I was told that there are two approaches, internal and external analysis, micro and macro analysis, right? Internal environment and internal and external means the factors and forces which are internal. Those factors we call as internal environment factors. If it is external, that factors we called as external environment factors, right? Physical resources, stock management, finance, R&D, research and development, purchasing, manufacturing, account. These are the internal environment. So external environments, right, consist micro and macro forces that are external to the market, right? Right, in the external environment consists actors and forces, right? So these are the actors, right? Consumers, competitor, intermediaries, suppliers, and public groups, right? Actors. These are the forces. Forces means special factors, right? So political and legal environment, economic environment, social and cultural environment, technological environment, natural environment, right? Actors and forces consist in the external environment, right? And then the micro and macro approach, right? So in the micro and macro approach, micro means if that factors and forces are directly influenced to the business. In the internal and external analysis, it considered the factor is whether internal or external. The micro and macro approach, that factors is directly affecting or indirectly affecting. If it is directly affecting, then it is a micro environment. If it is indirectly affecting, then it is a macro environment, right? So the actors in the external environments are considered as the micro factors, right? So the actors, suppliers, intermediaries, customers, competitors, publics, macro. So then we come to the macro environment. That's again the forces, the pestle factors, right? Okay, social environment we discuss in detail, right? Culture, subculture, core values, beliefs, secondary values, right? Population growth, family structure, geographical, women involved, workforce. We discuss how the opportunities are creating due to this. Economic environment, right? How the opportunities are creating in the economic environment, right? Dr. Mahathir Mohamad, how he identified the opportunities for the microfinancing. Hope I discuss with you the example, right? Technological environment, this is the most critical environment currently, right? Political and legal, right? So few users limitations, right? So basically we cover majority, 50% of the module is covered up to now. So then from next week onwards, you will learn about marketing aspect, risk, right? Ethics, marketing management side, right? This subject is entrepreneurship development and management, bit of management side. So during next few weeks, we will learn about that aspect, right? Risk, ethics, marketing aspect, management, right? Business models, value chain, likewise, several things you will learn, right? So last lecture, I will come and again, I will discuss few practical aspect, how practically you go and register your business as a sole proprietorship or as a partnership, or what are the documents that you need to field or present if you are planning to register your business as a company, right? What in the company set, what kind of documents that you need to submit, right? So in the last lecture, we'll have a little bit of practical side, right? Okay. So that is about the today's session. Any questions up to now? Any unclear area? Are you all there? Any unclear area? Hello, are you all there? Right, okay. If it is no question, so we can wrap up the today's session. Right? Any questions? Yes. Right. Okay. Right. So then we can wrap up the today's session. I will then next join for the last lecture, right? So we can discuss few revision questions, few practical aspect, right? Okay. Until good night for today. And we'll meet in the last lecture and put your index number and the name, right? Okay, and thank you very much for the participation. We'll meet in the last lecture, right? Good night to all.